Okay, so Korean patch, and we'll try to cover it real quickly. First of all, starting with the new summoner skills. One each skill was added to some of the elements, and these skills are available at level 72. Okay, so first of all, the new Kina Water skill tree, Ice Protection, 30 second cooldown. It covers the HP of allies within the area and grants shield with snow crystals. If a team member has poison, reduces the cooldown of ice protection and removes all harmful effects. In addition, applies movement speed up to allies with movement speed down. So here are the multipliers. Looks like this is just a direct counter to the Dark Orbia mostly, right? And this is what the range looks like. It is a very, very big range. I'm not sure about the skill animation, but it looks pretty fast as well. And the Fire Orbia has received a new skill too, so Firewall, 15 second cooldown, creates a wall of fire to attack enemies within the area. The first hit removes invincibility applied to the enemy. The moving invincibility applies irresistible burn if Orbia has a provoke. Increases damage of the first hit. The firewall defeats damage every second for a certain time and applies defense down with a certain chance. So here's the range that she has. This sort of screams like a very good frontline slash cleave counter, since it applies burn, and if Orbia has provoke, which of course cleave and quite a few frontliners like paladins do, increases damage based on the first hit. The multipliers are pretty defense, and there's a defense break on a fire element as well, so no longer the wind element is the only one with the defense break, which could be pretty game changing. And now for Cleave, his wind skill 1 has been changed, or not changed, but a new one has been introduced. So strong wind, 10 second cooldown, creates a strong wind to attack enemies within the area 2 times and push them back. Each hit applies evasion down and removes a beneficial effect. 10 second cooldown for a double strip and double evasion down. I'm not sure how impactful evasion down will be. It mostly will buff up archers like the Sarian or magical archers. But a double strip on a 10 second cooldown, and this being AoE, this is game changing. And you can see the range. I'm not a big fan of the range, but I really like that it potentially hits the like enemies behind him as well. Like, I do like the targeting of his first skill, but the new one looks really strong as well. And lastly, the new Soleda skill 1. This applies to the wind element, and it's breeze on a 9 second cooldown. Shoots arrows consistently to attack random enemies within the area 5 times and remove the immunity applied to the enemy target with a certain chance. If Soleta has Fletch, which I believe you get from the second skill, applies undercoverable if immunity is removed as well. So 35% chance to remove immunity, however it does hit 5 times, so it is most likely bound to remove an immunity or 2. Or if you're like attacking a single target, there's a very, very good chance that it will remove that immunity. And here's what it looks like. It's basically a single target attack, but it hits up to 5 times, and it will hit random enemies if they are stacked up closer. Okay, and then some big changes to bombs. So first of all, you can stack 3 bombs at once. Each time a bomb is applied, it basically stacks with the previous one up to 3. And the damage you do with those accumulates, so the more bombs you have, the more damage it deals. When the bomb explodes, it deals damage that stacked throughout the application process, and it stuns the enemy as well. And this is a big one, bombs ignore defense, so the damage will be much, much higher. And as you can see, even when a bomb is cleansed with any like regular cleansing effect, the damage and the stun is still dealt. So if you want to defuse it, you need to use a skill that specifically removes these bombs, such as the Water Mermaid, the Fire Garuda, and units like that. A small change to Kina's skill too. So basically the new level 70 skill, the healing and the effects you get are basically the same, but it only applies the effects twice instead of 4 times. This means that you will no longer be able to stack Teshar or the Light Phoenix buffs as fast as you were previously able to. And to round off the summoner changes, the Water Orbia, the newly added mana increasing effect, has been changed to only work on summoners, because previously Even if your monster received the mana cost up, all of your skills would cost quite a lot and you were able to stack those, so in the end your skills costed like 3 or 4 times more than they should. So yeah, that has been changed to summoners only. And with the changes to bombs, a lot of units that have interactions with bomb have received a balance patch. So first of all, the fire para captain, this guy is someone who detonates bombs, so his first skill now has some HP scaling damage. It also has a little bit lower chance to stun, but since this is a multi-hit, in the end it is a little bit higher overall. And also his second skill, now it has some HP damage as well, and whenever it explodes the bomb, it actually receives a damage dealt up, so those bombs should potentially do way more damage. And the same thing to the ultimates, very similar to the skill 2, it now has some HP scaling and it will do more damage if the enemy has a bomb. And for the rest of the bombers, I'll go over them super quickly, because the main thing that changes about them is that whenever the bomb explodes, it will now stun, and the scalings of the bomb damage. So the fire joker will now have 49% bomb damage based on the duration of the bomb. So every second the bomb will do 49% damage. Basically, if the bomb stayed for 10 seconds, it would do 490%. If it stayed for only 2 seconds, it will only do like 98% multiplier. And the second skill, it has a little bit of lower damage, but it also has a level burn added instead of level 1. Very similar to the Water Joker, the scaling has been lowered to 47% per second. The damage on that second skill was lowered, but the frostbite was increased to level 2. And also, whenever you have invincibility, you have a 100% chance to freeze with your second skill. Also, as a nice addition, it looks like you will be reviving with 50% of your HP instead of 10%, and the cooldown of your abilities will be lowered whenever you revive. So this opens up a lot of potential for the Water Joker, since even before the bomb change, I really liked his kit, especially in Arena and Brawl, so we'll see how that works out. Again, similar changes to the Dark Joker, the bomb multiplier has been changed to 47%, and for one of his skills, it is a bit expensive, however, it also adds an effect that you cannot remove any harmful effects from your allies if you have been hit with the skill while you have a bomb. And a very similar thing on your ultimate, essentially, if you have a bomb, you are not able to remove any harmful effects. It's basically the same effect as with, I believe Ophelia has it, and whoever else, right? So, pretty significant if you have him, yeah? Fire Cobalt Bomber as well, as you can see now, if the target is a summoner, mana consumption is increased. So, you do get the mana cost up on this guy if you are hitting a summoner. This could be pretty big, because mana cost up is a very powerful debuff. And the bombing skill of this guy also destroys 15% of their health if the target is holding a bomb. Now the Water Cobalt Bomber, I mean, this patch is filled with bomber buffs. First of all, the bombing skill actually got reduced to only 3 mana, and the multiplier was changed to 49%, and once the bomb explodes, it will of course stun. And I believe this is the second skill, so this one will now, whenever you explode the bomb, it will do additional damage by 2 levels for 20 seconds, as you can see. So that's pretty big. It also freezes whenever you hold the bomb. So yeah, big buffs, big buffs. The same thing with the ultimate, much higher damage overall, and you also receive damage taken up level 3 whenever you are holding the bomb. The Wind Cobble Bomber actually received a cool change as well. So first of all, the bombing skill was changed similar to the water one, 3 mana. The multiplier has been changed, and it also reduces cooldown of his other skill if a bomb is applied. On top of that, look at that, increasing skill cooldown. And if the target has a bomb, no recovery will be granted, so basically a heal block. And if the target does not have a bomb, it will be given a bomb. So basically both of his skills will grant a bomb to the enemy. And the same thing with the ultimate, as you can see, heal block if there is a bomb, and yeah, if the target does not have a bomb, it will be given a bomb. The light cobalt bomber is very similar to the wind one, so the first skill was also lower than mana and the multiplier was changed. And his second skill has very, very similar effect to the wind one, so first of all, if the target is holding a bomb, it will apply block beneficial effect removal, which prevents you from cleansing the bomb. And if the target does not have a bomb, it will be given a bomb. And the same thing with the ultimate, just a little bit higher multipliers. Now the Wind Oracle Sierra, since she's a bomber as well, she got some changes too. So first of all, the bomb multiplier was of course changed, and the second skill will not only explode the bomb, but also grant skill cooldown, or not skill cooldown, but skill slowdown. Basically, this means skill deacceleration to enemies within the area. The same thing for the ultimate, it explodes the bomb and it will grant skill deacceleration in the area. Now for the Dark Oracle, the changes are not as big. So first of all, the multiplier has been changed. It looks like there is some changes listed here, but from what I've read, it mostly looks like it's only in the wording, right? Because previously the cooldown gets reduced if the strip is successful, and the same thing is written here. So maybe I missed something, but yeah, I don't see any changes there. For the ultimate, again, the only change is the multiplier as well. And now that we have received bomb buffs, we of course need to receive some buffs to the anti-bomber unit. So the main one is the Water Mermaid. And first of all, her first skill now has a bomb cleanse as well. The shield itself has been lowered, but since this is a 2 mana skill, it could be a very good emergency sort of cleanse for one of your units. And her second skill, previously it removed bombs, but now once it successfully removes a bomb, it also has some neat little beneficial effects. So first of all, it will also cleanse 2 harmful effects. It will give you immunity for 14 seconds, and it will give you 1 level of continuous recovery for 20 seconds. And of course, the same thing with the ultimate. So the immunity will last for 20 seconds. It will cleanse all harmful effects, and it will give you level 2 of continuous recovery. The Fire Monkey King also received a few buffs. I'm not sure whether this is related to bombs, but it might be. So first of all, for the, I believe this is the first skill, the lifesteal of this has been buffed a little bit from 20% to 30%. And for the other skill, it looks, no, oh, this is the passive, right? The passive effects have been changed a bit. So now, instead of getting more attack, you are getting less damage by 1 level for 14 seconds. I believe that is at 30% at level 1. Also, when an enemy attempts to apply crowd control, you recover 5% HP instead of 7.5, and you will decrease debuff effect by 2 seconds. So basically, if a buff is applied a debuff applied for you for 8 seconds, it will only last 6. The Water Monkey King received some buffs as well. So first of all, for, I believe this is the second skill if I'm not wrong, so the damage multipliers have been buffed a bit, and all attacks except the last hit will now ignore any beneficial effects. So any shields, any invincibility, you will do damage through those. And for the passive, there has been quite a bit of effects added. So first of all, critical strike against under control effect. So basically, if the target has a stun, is increased. When a target has CC effect, the crit damage is increased by 80%. If there's no buffs, then there will be a chance to stun for 3 seconds. If the target is stunned, you also have a chance to steal mana with a 50% chance. And when attacking a stunned target or successfully stunning it, yeah, I got cut off for a bit. So yeah, basically the enemy cannot receive any buffs as well, so it will apply the block beneficial effects for 14 seconds. And a very similar thing to the second skill is happening to this ultimate. So basically all attacks apart from the last one will ignore any buffs, and the damage has been buffed significantly. Chibu, the Fire Pioneer, received a buff, and I'm not gonna lie, this is a very weird one, but his first skill, previously it did damage based on attack and max HP, as well as applied block beneficial effects. Now, if the target has no beneficial effects, the damage of this skill was buffed by 15%. I'm not sure, but I guess maybe it will help him be a little bit more useful in the PvP. The Fire Imp champion, since he is also a bomber, has been adjusted as well, so the initial damage he deals was lowered. However, the bomb has been adjusted and the multiplier has been changed to 44.3%. And of course, the most budget counter to bombs is the 3-star Fire Garuda, so since he is also a bomb cleanser, he now successfully removes bombs from nearby allies, and whenever removing a bomb, he will also cleanse another weakening effect, as well as apply skill acceleration level 1 for 20 seconds, which is quite big. And now let's run over some other quality of life changes. So first of all, as you can see, the damage in battlefield has been lowered, or rather just critical damage, by 75%. This also means that our critical damage based units will not be as effective, and it also opens up potential for non-crit units such as like the weak point attacks or maybe even fixed damage units to shine a little bit more in there. And of course, since this is a Halloween themed patch, the new transmogs have been added. So these are the 5-star Undying transmogs and the 5-star Dragon Knight transmogs. Both of these are available through the shop with IRL money, of course. And the third transmog, the Howl transmog, will be available through the Howl Gold Coins event. We also got some info about the Season 3 Mythic gear that will be dropping from Hero Dates. Of course, NA and Global servers are still only on Season 1, but in the Korean server, Season 3 is approaching, so here are the set effects. So while the season is in effect, one of the sets will give a teammate a 35% chance to remove a shield and invincibility whenever using a skill on any target with a 2-second effect. And once the season is off, that chance will be dropped to 15% and it will have a 10-second cooldown. The chance is whatever, but the cooldown is a bit much, and I feel like this will just not be that useful once the season ends. And the second set, which is actually probably the first PvE set that we have, so with attack speed increase, the damage dealt during a normal attack increases by 10% for the summoner and 30% for monsters, yeah? And once the season ends, that damage will be cut in half, so 5% for summoners and 15% for monsters. Also, as promised, there are some changes happening to Galagos. So first of all, the movement speed of the summoner will now be increased in all stages, not just stages that have no enemies, such as the tower room or whatever. There were like chest room or whatever. And also, first and fourth floors will no longer have those annoying elite boss passive skills such as like endure, as you can see here, endure, continuous healing, non-recoverable, that was probably the worst one. So yeah, those are being removed from there, and eventually there will potentially be more changes to the Galagos ruins as promised. Now, another neat change is that the amount of items you can purchase from the discount code is being increased. Not the discount code, but the discount shop from the general merchant. So the lowest tier gloves and pickaxes are getting increased to 30 times a week. The blue tier ones are getting changed to 20 times a week, and the purple ones to 10 times a week. As for events, there is of course the Explore Howl House events, which I will cover most likely in a separate video, just to see how many coins you need to get, how the dates are looking, and I'll give this info from the Korean server, and I'll showcase it maybe before the event even starts in your server. And lastly, before we go, I want to pay attention to this. Usually these are like bug effects, or rather bug fixes, or more quality of life fixes. After digging through all of these, I want to pay attention to this. So the damage of skills used after the world boss transformation is reduced and adjusted. This means once the boss transforms at his phase, which happens at like what, 1 minute 20 or 1 minute 15 left, the damage will be reduced, which is probably very huge because it's very hard to survive some of the attacks, and also adjusted. Hopefully this means less RNG and more sort of strategic gameplay being added. And yeah, that's about it for the Korean patch. We'll be back with hopefully some more videos in the future, and peace.